Okay, welcome to signal processing class, digital signal processing class, that is on chapter 2, efficient computation of discrete Fourier transform. Okay, let us consider one example here. Find x of k for the 8-point sequence, x of n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 using DITFFT method. So this is the example that we are supposed to solve, and you already know that algorithm, that how we write this, right? So one of the very important point that you are supposed to understand here is always try to write the input in the form of bit reversal order, and output will be in the regular order, right? So you can observe x of n is in the form of bit reversal. So x of 0, x of 4. So just see here, 100 is the equivalent binary value of x of n. If you bit reverse this, so what you will going to get? 00. If you bit reverse this, what you will going to get? 100. So that is equivalent value is 4, right? Similarly, here the 010 is the equivalent binary value of 2, and even if you go for bit reversal, it remains same, hence x of 2 itself. But whereas in case of x of 3, it is 0111, and if you reverse this, so this will be 110. Similarly, whenever you write this value, you should go apply input in the form of bit reversal, okay? This especially for DITFFT method. And for DIFFT method, once again this process will be different, okay? And you already know I am trying to write all the twiddle factors, all these twiddle factors in terms of W8 to the power, okay? So here it was the 1 point DFT. When I say that 1 point DFT, it is Wn to the power of k, okay? So it is as usual, even if I write, see, one, it is nothing but 1 point DFT, which means k value will be only 1, that is W1 to the power of 0. So it is as good as writing W1 to the power of 0, or W4 to the power of 0, or W8 to the power of 0. So we maintain a one constant value, because it is not all the time. If I able to calculate W8 to the power of 0, W8 to the power of 1, W8 to the power of 2, W8 to the power of 3, if I calculate these 4 values, that is sufficient for me, right? So that's where I go with putting W8 to the power of 0 instead of W1 to the power of 0. So similarly here also, W8 to the power of 0. And coming to this point, it is W8 to the power of 2, and here we are supposed to write W8 to the power of 0. I already told you in the one of the video where W4 to the power of 0 we replace with W8 to the power of 0, and here it is supposed to be 4 point DFT, right? So 4 point DFT, W4 to the power of 1. So W4 to the power of 1 is equal to W8 to the power of 2. So in simple, if you observe carefully, W4 to the power of 1 and W8 to the power of 2. So if I write its equivalent in terms of e to the power of j 2 pi by n, what is n value here? The n value is 4. Okay, what is small n value? Small n value is 1. So that is equal to W8 to the power of 2 can be written as e to the power of minus j 2 pi by n is 8, capital N is 8. What about small n? Small n value is 2. Okay. Now look at this, 2 ones are, 2 twos are, 2, 2, it is 4, and 4 twos are. Once again, if you observe carefully, so it is e to the power of minus j pi by 2, that is equal to e to the power of minus j pi by 2 itself. So hence, instead of writing W4 to the power of 1 here, I am supposed to write W4 to the power of 1, because it is a 4 point DFT we calculated. Instead of writing W4 to the power of 1, we try to replace this w4 to the power of 1 by w8 to the power of 2. Okay, similarly here also we are supposed to write w4 to the power of 0. Instead we write w8 to the power of 0. Sometimes some textbooks will not write because w8 to the power of 0 is 1. So that's the way they follow. Both are correct, and it's better like if you have a habit of writing that w8 to the power of 0, because else you will be in a confusion. So always have a habit of writing that w8 to the power of 0, w8 to the power of 2. Okay, so this we call it as stage 1. What is stage 1? Stage 1 is a calculation of the 1 point DFTs, right? So this is 1 point DFT, where you will get out of this, you will going to get a 2 point DFT output now. Okay, 1 point DFT, 1 point DFT. Combining x of 0 and x of 1, x of 4, you will going to get, so a of 0, a of 1, you will going to get 2 point DFTs here. So output is 2 point DFT. Again, combining x of 2, x of 6, you will going to get 2 point DFT, that is b of 0, b of 1. Again, here you will going to get c of 0, c of 1, d of 0, d of 1. Fine. Then combining these 2 point DFT. So here I have 2 point DFT, here also I have 2 point DFT. Combining this, I am going to get in the next stage the 4 point DFT. So here I will going to get 4 point DFT. That's what we call it as a g of k to g of 3 values, and h of 0 to h of 3 values. Now combining these 4 point DFT, this and this, so finally I am going to get output of 8 point DFT. So this is very very important. Okay, so with this, I just erase this. Now with this algorithm we continue to solve the next example, that is solving the given x of n, which is 8 point DFT. So we'll try to write a n. So before to that, I'll just, okay, now this is how the final the intermediate stage output and the final output I have written, but right now we go for solving the examples. So look at this. So input is bit reversal order, very important. So x of 0 is 0, so this is 0th position and 1 position. So since this is the first example, like 0, 1, 2, 3, it is not difficult for you to write the order here. X of 4 is 4, x of 2 is 2, x of 6 is 6, x of 1 is 1, x of 5 is 5. The same thing is not true with some other example. Maybe for example 1, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So you should be very careful while writing such examples. Okay, just here my intention is just to show you how you are supposed to perform the calculations. Now once again, what is the first stage output? So what we are supposed to do, x of 0, how do you get a of 0 now? Okay, a of 0 is equal to, what is that, input x of 0 plus, right, plus w a to the power of 0 x of 4, is it not? So now what is x of 0 and x of 4? X of 0 is 0, x of 4 is 4. So this, you remember the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? This is my x of n. Okay, what is x of 0? It is 0. Plus w8 to the power of 0 is 1 into x of 4 is 4. So what will be the first value? So a of 0 value will be 0. So what we did? So I just, x of 0 is added with, x of 0 is added with x of w8 to the power of 0 into x of 4. Fine. So this is what we performed here. Okay, well performing this, so here look at this,
x of 4 is 3, right sir?
X of 4 is, okay, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. X of 4 is 4, no?
Okay, sir.
X of 4 is 4 itself. 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay. So x of 0, x of 1, and x of 7. I hope your confusion got cleared. Now, look at this. This is how the first stage is going to be performed. X of 0, x of 4 I have. Okay. Now, what we did? We multiplied this value with a Twiddle factor. So, strictly speaking, as per my this one, so this is n by n point DFT, where this is almost n 8 by 8. So, I cannot divide anymore. What we did first, W8 was divided by 2, n by 2 point DFT, we got W4, right? 4 point DFT we calculated. Later on, 5, W4 to the power of 4 is divided by 2 and we got 2 point DFT. Once again, W4 to the 2 point DFT is divided and we got W1, right? So here, W8 to the power of 0. While coming back, A of 0, we got it. While coming back, A of 1 is calculated. So, which is A of 1 plus W1 to the power of 1 into, A of 0 is equal to X of 0 plus W1 to the power of 1, X of 4. This is how the values are supposed to be calculated. Similarly, A of 1 is equal to X of 0, X of 1, is okay. Now it is once again what 1 point DFT. 1 point DFT means again I should go for calculating x of n minus k, which means that n by n. So that is again n minus k means once again I should go for x of 0 itself, right? X of 0 plus W4, k value is second value I am calculating. So it is 0, it is 1, W1 to the power of 1, so into X of 4 again. So here what we did, so W1 to the power of 1, again I can rewrite it as minus W1 to the power of 0. So this is minus 1. So finally, to calculate A of 1, it is nothing but X of 0 minus W8 to the W1, I will replace with W8 to the power of 0 into X of 4. Okay, so to calculate A of 1, so again 0, X of 0 is 0 minus W8 to the power of 0 is 1, again the value of x of 4 is 4. So therefore the value is minus 4. Is it clear? Okay. Now I'll move back. So what we did? So it is nothing but the first stage, it is nothing but first we go for addition, second value we go for subtraction. That's it. So that's where you got it. It is minus 4. So it is minus 4. I hope minus is visible properly here. It is minus 4. I hope this is visible. Okay. Now, this is first, in the first stage, we got the value of A of K value. Okay. Now, further is to obtain the B of K. B of K, again, odd and even values. Okay. Now, once again, X of 2, so B of 0, is obtained by X of 2 is added with, so this is X of 2 plus W8 to the power of 0 is 1 itself. I don't write it now onwards, for the at least for the first stage. So next is X of 6. So this is nothing but 2 plus 6, you got 8. Then what is the next value? So this is 2 minus 6, that is minus 4 here. So this is A, B of 0 and B of 1. Next, further X, C of 0 is obtained by adding these two. That is 5 plus 1, 6. Again, to obtain C of 1, it is just nothing but a subtraction process. So anyways, this value is multiplied. So always remember, these two values supposed to be multiplied. Multiply and make it minus. Okay. negate that value. So 5 into 1, so plus 1, so that is 5 minus 1. So for 1 minus 5 here, this is x of 1 minus 5, so that gives me minus 4. Here also 3 plus 7 into wa to the power of 0, so therefore 7 plus 3 will give me 10, and final here it is 3 minus 7, which gives me minus 4. So here the first stage is we done with the first stage. So later on what we are supposed to calculate, once we obtain a of k, a of k considering as an input, considering a of k as an input, so we try to calculate g of k values. So we already know how to calculate, or we know that particular equation to calculate g of 0, g of 1, g of 2 and g of 3, right? So now we are supposed to obtain g of k values here. So what we should do, how do you write the g of k? Let me write the equation for g of k here. So the g of k is represented by, can you tell me or help me out how to write the g of k equation here? So it is nothing but a of k plus w n to the power of k. It is w n, how much, how many point here, w n by 2, right, n by 2, and b of k, b of k, and actually from the original value, almost here in this case, if n is 8, so this is 4, w4, right, so this is w4 to the power of k in this particular equation. Now since this is 4 point DFT, how many values we will going to get? G of 0, G of 1, G of 2, G of 3, only those values will going to get the answers. Now g of 0, what is g of 0? It is a of 0 plus, so here I should replace this with w8 to the power of 0, b of 0, right? So this is the first value. If you remember these values properly from my previous lecture, that will help me to calculate that itself will help you to calculate the values. Now g of 1 is nothing but w a of 1 w 8 to the power of 1, w 8 to the power of 2, because w 4 to the power of 1 actual value, and I told you I will replace this with w 8 to the power of 2. Okay, so this into b of 1, fine. Okay, this is the value. Now we need to calculate and g of 3. G of 3 is obtained by, once again I need to subtract, that's it, a of 0. So I told you, so these will be the kind of periodic values. So once again, so look at this, if you calculate g of 0, that is sufficient. Okay, what we do, we multiply these two, we performed this in the first stage here itself, just negate this and perform subtraction with a of 0. What about g of 4? G of 4 is equal to a of 1 and w8 to the power of 2 p of 1. You have these two values, you will be having these two values, just subtract them. Okay, now the point is, what is the value? W8 to the power of 0 is 0, 1. What about w8 to the power of 2? How much it is? You need to calculate, right? So here let me calculate all the values, because later in stage here also I need w8 to the power of 0, w8 to the power of 1, w8 to the power of 2, w8 to the power of 3. So let me calculate all the values. I'll just teach you how to calculate these values. Let us try to write all the values here. Okay. W8 to the power of 1. So how do you calculate w8 to the power of 1? E to the power of minus j 2 pi. K value is 1, right, and 8, right? So now this is 2 1s are 2 4s. So this is e to the power of minus j pi by 4. And if I write this in terms of cos, cos pi by 4 minus j sine pi by 4. Okay, what is cos pi by 4? Anyone? What is cos pi by 4 value? Cos of pi by 4. Prajakta, are you there?
1 by root 2, sir.
Huh?
1 by root 2.
1 by root 2. If you divide it and let me tell, give me the answer in terms of decimal.
0.707.
Okay. Either you can take this 1 by root 2 as rightly she said, or else you can go for 0.707 minus j 0.707. I take this in terms of decimal because later in point of time I need to multiply this with some value, right? So that's where I always make sure that I write in terms of decimal itself. Okay, next. Okay, thank you, Prajakta. Now, next. Devraj, is there? Devraj?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Devraj, tell me the answer for this. W 8 to the power of 2 can be written as W 8 to the power of 2 pi by 8 into 2, right? So this will give me e to the power of minus j pi by 2. So what's the answer now? Cos pi by 2 minus j sin pi by 2. What can I write here? What is the value of W 8 to the power of 2 here onwards?
Minus 1, sir.
Minus? Check it.
Minus 1.
Check it. So this is 0, obviously, right? Cos 90 is 0. Minus, I cannot neglect this j, Devraj. Minus j, sin 90 is 1. So finally, the value is minus j, not minus 1. Okay? Next. Okay. Agna. Agna.
Yes, sir.
Tell me the value for W 8 to the power of 3. This is once again what you are supposed to, e to the power of j 2 pi by 8 into 3. Tell me the answer. It is e to the power of minus j 3 pi by 4. Minus j 3 pi by 4, right? What's the answer? For cos minus 0.707. okay, for sine it remains same, right? It is 3 pi by 4. Pi by 4 and 3 pi by 4, you will get one or the same. Okay, so again it will be minus 0.707, right? So just look at the value of W 8 to the power of 1 and W 8 to the power of 3. W 8 to the power of 1, see here you need to remember W 8 to the power of 0, W 8 to the power of 1, W 8 to the power of 2, W 8 to the power of 3. Only 4 values you are supposed to remember. Okay. W 8 to the power of 0 is 1. It will be remembered as usual. And W 8 to the power of 1, if you remember this value, that is sufficient. Because its value is pi by 4. So pi by 4 means cos pi by 4. Cos pi by 4 and sin pi by 4 were one or the same, right? But here it is 0.707 minus j 0.707. Just reverse this. Just put a negative for this. That's it. You will going to get W 8 to the power of j. So no need to calculate once again. Okay. Now obviously this is minus j. So these value you are supposed to remember. I told you conceptually how do you get these values of w8 to the power of 0, w8 to the power of 2, w8 to the power of 3 as all the values. But it is very easy to remember on your own at any point of time. So unless you remember, you have a concept, you can also derive the values from knowing, going to the conceptual way. Okay. Okay, I'll just make some space here. Okay, now you go on calculating the values of g of 0, g of 1 quickly. So few students has few students go for calculating g of 0 and calculating the g of 1. I'll come back and I'll assign the work now. Okay, now you got to know few of you can start calculating g of 0, g of 1, and few of you go for calculating g of 1 and g of 2 and 3. Okay, Abhishek, Aditya, VM, Spurti, Bharat, Chaitra, you just calculate and give me the answer for g of 0 and g of 1. Devidas, Devraj, Geeta, Gaura, Harsha, Harshita, Hrithik, just go on giving me the values of g of 2 and g of 3. So I got one answer. G of 0 is 12. G of 0 is 12. Okay, correct. Lohit, give me a correct answer. So anybody else? Aditya, Hiraymat, okay. Okay, G of 1 values. G of 1. So this is g of 1, g of 1 is minus plus 4, plus 4j. Check it once again. G of 1, Chaitra Kulkarni. Carefully, be careful in putting the negative value and positive value. Yeah, Abhishek and Janvi got the correct answers. It is not plus 4 Chaitra, it is minus 4 plus 4j. Fine. What about g of 3, g of 3, g of 2 and g of 3? I need two more values, g of 2 and g of 3. G of 2 and g of 3. G of 2 is minus 4. Okay, Karthik. Next, g of 3. Quick. So, if you have calculators, that will make your job easy. Yeah, very good. G of 3 is minus 4 minus 4j. Minus 4 minus 4j. It is minus 4 minus 4j. So as I told you, g of k is a 4-point DFT. Okay, g of k is 4-point DFT. Definitely, g of, so that it must follow the property of symmetry, right? It must follow the property of symmetry. See here, g of z k is equal to g star of n minus k. Okay, now g star of, when you write g of 3 value, so this is nothing but 4-point DFT. Right now it is 4 minus 3, so So this must be equal to complex conjugate of g of 1. So g of 1 you got minus 4 plus 4j. So here first value you already received it as 12. Second value, that is g of 1 value, is minus 4 plus 4j. And I told you many times, this will be complex conjugate of this one. This is minus 4 minus 4j. Okay, and this is 4 minus 4. Okay, you got these values. I'll just go back to the diagram. Okay, now how do you obtain? So look at this. Now stop calculating and concentrate here. So g of 0 is calculated a of 0 b of 0, right? So it is b of 0 is multiplied with this, and this is going to be multiplied. I keep it aside. So I perform the addition with a of 0, so here, so that I will going to get g of 0 as 12. Immediately I already have this value. Okay, here onwards perform this in this way so that your calculation will be much more faster. Anyways, you will be having a multiplication value of b of 0 into w a to the power of 0. Just subtract the value with a of 0, you will going to get g of 2, right? So immediately you will going to get this value. Next, instead of calculating sequentially a of 0, a of 1, I made my job little simple. I calculated g of 0 first. Immediately I will calculate g of 2, because the reason is, anyways, multiplication process is done here. Just negate that value, subtract with a of 0, you will going to get the answer. Okay, so that is here 4 plus 8, and here it is 4, 8 into 1, I just multiply minus the value, that's it. Next, b of 1 is the value is multiplied with w8 to the power of 2. What is the value here, w8 to the power of 2? I just multiply my value with point, the w8 to the power of 2 is j. I keep multiplied and my answer is ready, minus 4j. So what I should do? I just add this, that is minus 4. So here, it is minus 4 into the value is minus j. So here this is a plus 4j. So therefore we will going to get plus 4j immediately. Later on, immediately I negate this value. So I will going to get minus 4j here. I just take my value from a of 1. I will subtract. So minus 4 minus 4j immediately. Is this clear? Okay. Similarly, use this technique to solve or to obtain h of 0, h of 1, h of 2, h of 3. What we are supposed to do? Let me erase this. Okay, it is already saved. Okay. Now, c of 0 is calculated with multiplying d of 0 with w8 to the power of 0. W8 to the power of 0 is how much? 10. I just add this with c of 0. So this is nothing but 10 plus 6. So answer is 60. Then finally, immediately what we do? I'll calculate h of 2 instead of going to h of 1. So this is minus 1, which means that minus 1 is multiplied with these two multiplication values. So I'm going to get minus 10 here. So this is supposed to be added with 6. 6 plus of minus 10, in that way you read it. So therefore 6 minus 10, you're going to get minus 4. Then once again, this value is minus j. So perform these two, that is, you're going to get plus 4j, right? Plus 4j, and here what is this value? Minus 4 plus 4j, and here it is minus 4. So we are going to get, when you multiply with a negation, so once again this will be positive, minus 4 minus, so here it is plus 4j, right? Okay, plus 4j, so here it will be minus 4j, minus 4 minus 4j, right? So now, how do you obtain the values of x of k, final values? Now it is, how do you obtain the values? So now, to obtain x of k values, it is nothing but g of k plus w n to the n by 2. It is n h of k. Okay, and this is where you will going to get half values. Half values, that is 0 to n by 2 values. N by 2 minus 1, that is 0 to 3 values. X of 0 to x of 3, you will going to get like this. Next, later on, this will be complex conjugate k minus n by 2 plus w n to the power of k h of k minus n by 2. So you will going to get rest of n by 2 to n minus 1 values, right? So this is just a complex conjugate values. Just try this and let me know the final answer here. So it is, we received these values. So to calculate x of 0, it is nothing but h of 0 is multiplied with w a to the power of 0. Then further it is going to be added with, so this is going to be added with g of 0. Therefore it is 12 plus 16. So we will going to get 28 here. So immediately I will fetch the value. Which one? I'll perform this operation immediately, because I already performed multiplication. I don't want to waste the time here. So this becomes minus 16. So 12 minus 16 will give me minus 4. Right? Okay. W8 to the power of 1. What is the value of W8 to the power of 1? It is minus 0.707. Sorry, plus 0.707 minus j 0.707. Multiply the value with h of 1. Okay, and once you have that, you simply go for adding with g of 1. So what answer you are going to get? You must get this answer. Minus 4 plus 9.65. J times 9.65. Are you getting this? Will you solve like this? Now immediately I will be calculating g of 1. I just negate this answer. I just negate this multiplication answer, and I will perform the addition with g of 1, so that I am going to get x of 5. X of 5. Right? Next. Are you doing this? Are you able to follow me here? Next, h of 2 is multiplied with w8 to the power of 2, that is minus j. Here it is, I will write 0.707 minus j 0.707. So this and this is supposed to be multiplied. Next, and here w8 to the power of is minus 707 minus j 0.707. Okay. Now perform the multiplication. Minus 4 into minus j, it is plus 4j, plus 4j, g, h of 2, g of 2, right? H of 2, g of 2. Okay, that is minus 4 plus 4j. And once again, immediately I perform this operation, that is minus 4, I take it as it is. Then I will negate here. When I negate this, so this is plus 4j, instead here it becomes minus 4j, so therefore minus 4j. This is the answer. And finally, you perform this multiplication operation with this. Minus 4 minus j 4, into minus 0.707 minus j 0.707. Perform this operation, keep it to aside. Then once again h of 3 should be added with g of 3 to get minus 4 plus j 1.6, and negate this here. You keep it aside, then take g of 1. So this is not g of 1 here, g of 3. Okay, g of 3 value with h of 3, so you will going to get x of 7. I'll come back to Google Meet. Let me know if you have any doubts. Any doubts here? If not, what did you observe in case of x of k final values? Look at the value of x of 1 and x of 7. This is just a complex conjugate values you can observe, right? So look at this. Look at this, okay. 28 and x of 1 and x of 7. Observe carefully. X of 1 and x of 7. So x of 1 is minus 4 plus j 9.65, and x of 7 is going to have minus 4 minus j 9.65. If you observe carefully, x of 7 is nothing but complex conjugate value of x of 1, right? So that's where the we try to write here it as x of e k is equal to x conjugate of n minus k. That is what the symmetry property say about. Okay, so which means that if I say x of 7, this is equal to x conjugate of 8.DFT. It is, right? So 8 minus 7. So therefore, this must be equal to conjugate of 1. So 1 and 7 are complex conjugate, and next complex conjugate you find it in 2 and 6. Look at x of 2 and x of 6. 4 plus 4j minus 4 plus 4j minus 4 minus 4j, complex conjugate. And if you observe, x of 3 and x of 5 are complex conjugate once again. Okay, and I told you one more very important point. X of 0 is nothing but sum of your inputs, sum of all of your inputs. So it is nothing but 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6. If you observe this, it must be equal to 28. Okay, and which is nothing but a DC component. So that's where, and all other values, and apart from this, x of n by 2 value is also DC component here. X of n by 2 means 8 by 2, that is x of 4. Look at the x of 4. X of 4 is also DC component, which means that there is no J component. What do you mean by J? J is nothing but a frequency component. So there is no frequency component in the value of first X of 0 and X of n by 2. If it is 8.DFT, then 8.DFT X of 4 will be having a DC component. If it is 16.EFT, then X of 8 will be my DC component. Am I clear here? So these are the few important points that you are supposed to keep in your mind. I hope this example is clear to you. So if it is clear, then you take an example, one more example. Shall I proceed, guys? Or you have any doubts, I am back to Google Meet. Shall I proceed? Is there any doubts in solving? Let us solve one more example so that it will be comfortable for you. So once again, we will meet today afternoon 3 o'clock, maybe 5-10 minutes here and there, and we will solve one more example. I will give you this example. Try to solve that by till afternoon. Okay, x of n is equal. Yeah.
Sir, we have class at 3 o'clock, sir, today.
Which class?
Every Monday we will be having CMOS, sir.
Okay. The reason is, tomorrow, once again, I'm on leave. That's where Tuesday afternoon I kept my class, right? Any other timing today? 3 to 4, sir will be taking from 3 to 4?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Tomorrow I am on leave. Okay. Day after tomorrow I will take Wednesday my class is not there, but I will be engaging at 3 o'clock. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Take the value x of n equal to 1, 1, parallelly I will be writing in chat box also, -1, -1, 1, 1, 1, 3 times 1, -1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so this is the sequence. I read it out. Just cross verify. X of n equal to 1, -1, -1, -1, 1, 1, 1, -1. Clear? So consider this input. Try to solve for x of k using DITFFT method. Using DITFFT method.